In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how easy it is to add your own design to a baseball hat. So here's what you need. I got a cotton baseball hat. I cut this Adventure Awaits out of heat transfer or HTV vinyl. You can do that on Cricut, Silhouette, Scan and Cut, whatever you have. Make sure you reverse the design when you cut it so that when you put it on the hat, it's going to read correctly. And you can get this file for free on my blog at tararead.com. If you're not there already, there will be a link below this video. Then I'm going to be using the Cricut EasyPress, the flat one. They have a new one that is specifically designed for baseball hats. I don't do enough to really want to invest in that, so this works great. So I'm going to show you how to use this one. Then you need a way to make the hat hard so that your heat has something to press on. And there's two options. I sew, so I have this thing called a tailor's ham. And some of them are raised like this and others they're just like one piece. But tailors use them and sewers use them for sleeves and things like that. So it's kind of almost like a mini ironing board. Putting the hat on there works great if you have something like this. If you're going to do a lot of hats, you might want to look for one. But you don't have to. I like to use stuff from around the house. So go to your linen closet and find your least fluffy towel possible, because your fluffy ones are going to have more give when you're pressing. So you want to make as hard of a backing for your hat as possible. So I am going to use a bath mat because it's not fluffy at all. And I'm just going to fold that and roll it. And I'm going to put it in my, so it's rolled. I'm going to put it in the hat with this flattest part where we're going to press. So see, I have that like that. Shove it down there. And you might have to manipulate it a little bit. You just want to make sure your hat is smooth against the towel that you put under it. Then you're going to put your design where you want it, centered over this seam, if your hat has a seam like that, and usually at least a half inch off of the rim. I usually do hat designs about 3 inches by maybe 1.5 inches, 2 inches top, because you don't want it too close to the rim and you don't want it all the way up your head. So they're not huge designs. It's a great way to use little bits and pieces of extra heat transfer vinyl. Now we got the Cricut EasyPress heated up to 2. That's the temperature that you want. And now I'm just going to press that and move. We're going to do about 30 seconds. I'm just going to move it around the hat. You'll see I didn't get it hard enough. Oh no, that worked. So it came off. It looks a little bubbly to me, so I'm going to put this back on. I'm going to fix my towel so that it's giving me better even pressure behind, especially behind that arrow. I'm just going to go over that a little bit more. Be careful, do not touch this. It's very hot. You will burn yourself. Basically like a mini iron. And then you just want to make sure that all your letters and all the edges are down. I'm going to re-roll my towel. Now this just shows you it's not always perfect the first time, right? You want to make sure this plastic backing is always over your vinyl and that your iron, your mini heat press is never touching the vinyl directly. All right, and now adventure awaits. Anyway, super cute, super easy, heat on 2, support the back, keep this on there whenever the heat presses over it. So you can go grab that design at my website, tararead.com.